Charles XV of Sweden, Charles XV and IV, also Karl, Swedish, Karl XV and Norwegian, Karl IV was King of Sweden and Norway from 1859 until his death. Though known as King Charles XV in Sweden, he was actually the ninth Swedish king by that name, as his predecessor Charles IX had adopted a numeral according to a fictitious history of Sweden. He was born in Stockholm Palace, Stockholm in 1826 and dubbed Duke of Scania at birth. Born the eldest son of Crown Prince Oscar of Sweden and his consort Crown Princess Josephine, he would be second in line to the throne of his grandfather, the ruling King Charles XIV of Sweden. During his childhood he was placed in the care of the royal governess Countess Christina Ulrika Taube. When he was just 15, he was given his first officer's commission in 1841 by his grandfather the king. The aging King Charles XIV would suffer a stroke on his 81st birthday in 1844, dying little more than a month later. His successor would be his son, Charles's father Oscar, who ascended the throne as King Oscar I of Sweden. Upon his father's accession to the throne in 1844, the youth Charles was made a Chancellor of the Universities of Uppsala and Lund, and in 1853 Chancellor of Royal Swedish Academy of Arts. On February 11, 1846 he was made an honorary member of the Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences. The Crown Prince was Viceroy of Norway briefly in 1856 and 1857. He became Regent on September 25, 1857, and King on the death of his father on July 8, 1859. As grandson of Augusta of Bavaria, he was a descendant of Gustav I of Sweden and Charles IX of Sweden, whose blood returned to the throne after being lost in 1818 when Charles XIII of Sweden died. On June 19, 1850 he married in Stockholm Louise of the Netherlands, niece of William II of the Netherlands through her father and niece of William I of Prussia, German Emperor, through her mother. The couple were personally quite dissimilar. Louise was a cultured and refined woman, however, she was considered to be quite plain and Charles was disappointed with her appearance. Louise was in love with her husband, whereas he preferred other women, saddening her deeply. His well-known mistresses included the actress Laura Bergner, the Countess Josephine Spahr, Wilhelm and Schroeder, and the actresses Hannah Steirel and Elise Wasser, and the Crown Prince neglected his shy wife. On the other hand, his relationship to his only daughter, Louise, was warm and close. As Crown Prince, Charles' brusque manner led many to regard his future accession with some apprehension, yet he proved to be one of the most popular of Scandinavian kings and a constitutional ruler in the best sense of the word. His reign was remarkable for its manifold and far-reaching reforms. Sweden's existing municipal law, ecclesiastical law and criminal law were enacted appropriately enough under the direction of a king whose motto was, Land skall med lag byggas, with law shall the land be built. Charles also helped Louis Daguerre to carry through his reform of the Parliament of Sweden in 1866. He also declared the freedom of women by passing the law of legal majority for unmarried women in 1858. His sister Princess Eugenie became the first woman who was declared mature. Charles, like his father Oscar I, was an advocate of Scandinavianism and the political solidarity of the three northern kingdoms, and his friendship with Frederick Vie of Denmark, it is said, led him to give half promises of help to Denmark on the eve of the War of 1864, which, in the circumstances, were perhaps misleading and unjustifiable. In view, however, of the unpreparedness of the Swedish army and the difficulties of the situation, Charles was forced to observe a strict neutrality. He died in Malmö on September 18, 1872. Charles XV attained some eminence as a painter and as a poet. He was followed on the thrones of both Norway and Sweden by his brother Oscar II. In 1872, Charles XV had controversial plans to enter a non-morganatic marriage with the Polish Countess Maria Krasinska through the assistance of Ohan Demirjian, plans that aroused opposition both in the royal house and government and which were interrupted only by his death. By his wife, Louise of the Netherlands, Charles had two children, a son who died in infancy and a daughter who married the King of Denmark. The early death of his only legitimate son meant that he was succeeded on the throne of Sweden by his younger brother Oscar II. Charles also sired an illegitimate son, Carl Johan Bolander, the father of Bishop Nils Bolander, and daughter, Ellen Svensson Hammer, and it has been widely rumored that he had many more extramarital children. No subsequent king of Sweden to this day is Charles' descendant. However, his descendants have been on the thrones of Denmark, Luxembourg, Greece, Belgium, and Norway. A few weeks before Charles' death, his daughter Louise gave birth to her second son. The young Prince of Denmark became christened as grandfather Charles' namesake. In 1905 this grandson, Prince Karl of Denmark, ascended the throne of Norway, becoming thus his maternal grandfather's successor in that country, and assumed the reign name Haakon VII. The present king, Harald V of Norway, is Charles' great-great-grandson, through his father and mother. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.